Good morning. I say Bokatov again. It's us live again on Let There Be Light with Chimezie Okonkwo. And the God that has sent us here today, he sent us with a message for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ to come and encourage you that whatever challenges you're going through, God is there with you in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, let's pray. Father Lord, we hand over the studio, the airwaves into your mighty hand in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit of the living God, I say over to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Spirit of the living God, minister your word to your people in the name of Jesus Christ. Let the sick be healed in the name of Jesus Christ. Let marriages be restored in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let businesses receive life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, as you call the program, let there be light. Let there be light in their lives in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Wherever they need light, let there be light in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You're welcome to the program again, and I say shalom in Jesus' name. Over the weeks, we've been, you know, going through Let There Be Light, and then we moved into a topic, you know, very challenging one, that Jesus and the Christ, you know, trying to explain who Jesus was and who Christ is. You know, it's one person, but we must understand that they had different personalities, if you understand what I mean. So we tried to explain that last week, that Jesus was the one that came in the flesh. Christ was the one that rose by the Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The one that the Spirit came upon after the baptism was Jesus. But by the time he was killed and rose from the dead, he conquered death and rose. He became Lord and Christ. And I gave you a scripture in Acts chapter 2 where he made that clear. He said that God made him Lord and Christ. God made the same Jesus Lord and Christ. So that's what the Jesus I'm talking about and the Christ I'm talking about is one, but we must understand their personalities. Jesus came in the flesh. Christ was by the Spirit of God. Christ is an identity. It is not a name, just a man name. It's an identity, the identity of the Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So that is what we are dealing with. I will continue today in Jesus' name. By the grace of God, let's go to Psalm 51, where David spoke about the Spirit of God. He identified the Spirit. The Spirit had three different dimensions of the Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But it's the same Spirit of God. But now we're going to look at it. It says in Psalm 51, verse 10 to 12, it says, create in me, David was saying, and you say it in the name of Jesus Christ. You're telling God now, create in me a clean heart, O God. Create in me a clean heart. You need a clear heart to worship God. You need a clear heart to be closer to God. You need a clear heart to know how to deal with people around you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, say, create in me a clear heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Renew a right spirit within me. Say, the right spirit, renew it in the name of Jesus Christ. And in verse 11, it says, cast me not away. Cast me not away. What we don't need is God cast not away from his presence. We need the presence of God more than ever in this end time in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That's what people, the end time is around the corner, and people are still living their lives, enjoying their lives, not knowing what's about to happen. Look at accidents everywhere, earthquakes, everything happening, and people are not still worried. People are not still scared that this God can manifest anytime, anywhere, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But you will be protected in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He say, cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Now take not thy Holy Spirit from me, because you need it. Without the Spirit, you're almost as invalid. Because without this, it's the Spirit that reveals Christ to you. It is the Spirit that reveals Christ. As a believer, you must have the Spirit of God in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And through, but it's good that, like I said, we said last week, he said you confess Christ that is your Lord and Savior, but at the same time, you have to be baptized in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He said, then in verse 12, he says, restore unto me the joy of thy salvation. This is even one of the ones that hits me the most. He said, the joy of thy salvation. What is the joy of thy salvation? Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. All these things, those are the joy of thy salvation. All these things. But you have to seek ye first the kingdom of God. Matthew 6:33. He says, and all these things shall be added. Joy of thy salvation. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation. And uphold me with thy free spirit. So if you look at this scripture, you see the Spirit. He says the Spirit has three different dimensions or personalities, the spirit itself. He says here, he says it's a right spirit in verse 10. In verse 11, he says it's a Holy Spirit. In verse 12, he says it's a free spirit. So it's a right spirit. It cleanses you. It makes you right with God by the name of Jesus Christ, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As it makes you holy, it purifies you. It keeps you away from things that can defile you. A lot of times, I was a young man growing up, lived my life and everything, but it got to a stage. By the time I received the Holy Spirit of the living God, clubbing was deserted. Clubbing was deserted. Drinking was deserted. Smoking was deserted. In fact, I had challenges that even forced me to stop all those things. I had attacks. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, when God wants to bring you out, he knows how to bring you out. I was forced out. I was forced out by the Holy Ghost. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It says the Holy Spirit. So you have to be pure for the Holy Spirit to be able to use you in the name of Jesus Christ. It's a Holy Spirit. It's a right spirit. And it's a free spirit. He can use anybody. He can do anything in the name of Jesus Christ. He's not restricted in his ability. He's the same spirit in America. He's the same spirit in Africa, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He's the same spirit in Europe. He can function anywhere, at any time, through any medium, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He can speak to you through a t-shirt. He can speak to you through another person. He can speak to you directly. That is the spirit I'm talking about, the spirit of that raised up Christ from the dead. The spirit that raised up Christ from the dead. I was trying to explain last week that without that spirit, we probably will not be talking about Christ today. Without that spirit, because that spirit was mandated that the spirit will raise Christ from the dead. Jesus said, if I do not go away, the spirit will not come. My father will not send the spirit. It is imperative that I go, that the spirit might come. That is the spirit of the raised of Christ. That is the identity of Christ, is the identity of the spirit in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That's why you see, the Bible says we have the mind of Christ. 1 Corinthians 2:16. It says, but we have the mind of Christ. He said, we have the mind of Christ. Why do you have the mind of Christ? When you are operating in the name of Jesus Christ as a true believer, that has been delivered, giving your life to Christ. He says you have the mind of Christ. The same mind that was in him, that is in him now, is in you. That is what the Bible says, as he is, the Lord, as he is, so are we in this world. So are we. We are not expected to be any different. We are expected to be like God, manifest the power of God, heal the sick, raise the dead in the name of Jesus Christ. And that is why I speak life in the name of Jesus Christ. Life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. He said, we have the mind of Christ. And in Philippians 2:5, he says, let this mind be in you. Like I've quoted it a couple of times. He says, let the mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. Which was, now look at the word he used. He said, which was in Christ. Which is talking about Jesus, the Jesus that walked the earth, was. Let the mind be you that was in him. The mind that he could do anything. The mind that he came to conquer the world. The mind that he owned everything. The mind that Satan tried to tempt him and he conquered Satan and put him where he belonged. Under his feet in the mighty, mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. And now we'll go to Acts chapter 3, verse 6. I'm going to show you something there in the name of Jesus Christ, because I'm trying to explain that you have the name of Jesus. It is your spiritual name. Like I said, spirits don't have names. The people we see are the flesh. When a child is born, the parents look at the person, the flesh they are seeing, and they name the child. They don't see the spirit, but names are spiritual. But if you ask them who they gave the name, they say, oh, this boy, we gave it to our son, the boy or the girl. But names are spiritual, but they were giving it to the ones that came in the flesh. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But they are spiritual because they speak life or death into a person. So you can if you have a wrong name, you can be in torment, in deep torment, until you give your life to Christ. And even by the time you give your life to Christ, you the Holy Spirit will lead you. You change the name in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So Acts chapter 3, verse 6, I'm going to show you something. I want to show you that you are operating as a believer. You operate in the name of Jesus Christ. Nothing hinders you. You walk in that name. You move in that name. It becomes a name for you. That is why when you pray to God, you pray in the name of Jesus. You don't pray your own name. Your name, like I said last week, it becomes irrelevant. The name your parents give you, it becomes irrelevant. Now the Lord God, when he's hearing your prayer, he's hearing it, he's seeing it as the Lord himself, Jesus, praying on your behalf. Because you are now, you've now entered that authority, the authority you've been given to operate in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It says, we're going to Acts chapter 2, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Acts chapter 3, verse 6. Where Peter? Now, listen to what Peter said here. He says, then Peter said, silver and gold have I none. Silver and gold have I none. He didn't have, what can he offer? He said, I don't have anything, but the one I have. Listen, he said, but such as I have, I give. Such as I have. So you have the name of Jesus. You have the name of, it is your name in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It is your name. Before God, that is your name. Before God, what you've been bearing, you know, in the eyes of men, they call you Donald or anything. But it is not the name God, as a believer, the name God sees is the name of Jesus. That is your authority. Without that authority, you have no standing before God. He says, but such as I have, I give. It is only what you have you can give in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Somebody comes to ask you, oh, they need a car. You can't afford it. You can't give them a car. It's only what you have you give. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He says, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk in the name that I have, in the name that I know, in the name that I have seen it work miracles. Time without number. He said, rise up and walk in the name. I have it. Such as I have, I give. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And then we see in 1 Corinthians 11, 23, where the Apostle Paul wrote, he says, I received of the Lord that which I also delivered. So such as I have, I give. As the same thing Peter said. He says, such as I have, I give. Paul now saying, I have received of the Lord that which I also delivered unto you. What did he receive? The name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. By the time Christ Jesus rose from the dead, he became Lord and Christ. He became over the name Jesus. He is now Lord Jesus. That is why I say if you don't add Lord, you might be talking about any Jesus. There are too many Jesuses in the world. Too many South Americans, it is their regular names. But it is a spiritual name too. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He says, such as I have, I give. And then the Paul says, I have received of the Lord that which I also... And it was about the time he was about to administer the Holy Communion. He was talking about the Holy Communion there. So the Holy Communion is the covenant that renews and refreshes that name, the authority of that name to walk on your behalf in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And it will work for you in the name of Jesus. That authority in the name of Jesus Christ, as you believe, it will work in the name of Jesus Christ. That contract will be signed in your favor in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I say it will work in your favor. You that need a new car for your new job, it is coming in the name of Jesus Christ. After this ministration, you will receive a call that will give you that car in Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And then we'll go to 2 Chronicles 7:14. You see where God says, if my people who are called by my name, if my people, if they are called by my name, my people, they are called by my name. So it is not a sin to bear the name of Jesus. I say it. By the grace of God, it's a revelation. 2 Chronicles 7:14. You see what the Bible says there, 7:14. Now see what it says. It says, if my people which are called by my name, you think it's a sin to bear the name of Jesus, how come you bear the name of God? My people who are called by my name, may God be glorified. He said, my people who are called by my name, He said, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways. Then will I hear from heaven. I will forgive their sins and will heal their land. So what you are asking God for, you have to ask in the name, because if you are not called by that name, you can't access what God has in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. But if you are called by his name, he says, all these things will follow you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He says, I will heal your land. Listen to what he says. He says, you humble yourself and pray, seek my face. Because you are called by my name, you are under that covering. Because you bear your father's name, or your father's surname, we call surname. But now he's telling you, you are bearing my name, my people. If you are his people, you bear his name. You bear his name in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now it says in Philippians 2:9, let's see, where it talks about the name of Jesus. God has highly exalted him and given him a name that is above every name. And the mention of the name of Jesus, every knee should bow. Now listen, it says, wherefore God hath highly exalted him. Highly exalted him. So when you're operating in the name of Jesus Christ, you are highly exalted because you're still under that covering in the name of Jesus. He says, God has highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name. So when you operate in that name, you are above. I'm telling you, you know the challenges, you conquer all in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You conquer all. He says you are above. He says giving him a name that is above every name. That at the name of Jesus, at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow. So all your challenges begin to bow at the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I'm telling you, when you go before God, you say, Father, in the name of Jesus, the challenge is over, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He says that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth. So it doesn't matter what challenges they are. It doesn't matter what you are going through. It doesn't matter the situation you are facing, whether it is house issue. You are about to become your own landlord in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Houses you did not build, you will get. Have you read it in the scriptures? I will give them houses they did not build, vineyards they did not plant, in the name of Jesus Christ. He will water your gardens in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He says, at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow of things in heaven and earth and under the earth. He says, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. So at the storms bow at the name of Jesus. But who is the Lord? Jesus Christ. Storms bow at the name of Jesus. But who is the Lord? Jesus Christ. Now, I'm telling you that there is a transformation, there is an elevation. The name now, you operate in this name. You operate because while he was on the earth, he was Jesus. He was not Jesus Christ. He was Jesus. But by after baptism, death and resurrection, he became Lord and Christ. That is why you say Lord Jesus or Jesus Christ. Not just Jesus. But the name still works because he has been empowered to work for you. It has been empowered, it has been given to work for you in the name of Jesus Christ. You will not die in Jesus' name. You will not die. Watching me, you will not die. You will live in the name of Jesus Christ. You will live in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You will not die, no matter the verdict they have given you in the hospitals. It is overturned in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. For your own good in Jesus' name, and you will come back and testify for the glory of God, the Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now we'll go to John, the book of John. Lovely book. Lovely book, John 17. May God be glorified in Jesus' name. It says, John 17, let me start from verse 6. It says, I have manifested thy name. That is the name of the Lord. Jesus speaking. He says, Lord, he's speaking to his Father. He says, I have manifested thy name. So the name, what name did he manifest? The name he operated by was the name Jesus. So I've manifested thy name unto the men which thou givest me. Unto the men which thou givest me, not unto everybody. He said, unto the men which thou givest me, out of the world, thine they were, and thou givest them me. And they have kept thy word by the Holy Ghost in Jesus. And verse 9, he says, I pray for them. I pray not for the world. Imagine, he's not praying for the world. Because not he wasn't called for the world. He wasn't called for the world, but he was called for many. As many as received him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God. You need power to become the son of God. He says, I pray for them. I pray not for the world, but for them which thou hast given me, for they are thine. They are thine in the name of Jesus. He says in verse 11, he says, and now I am no more in the world. I am no more in the world. This is where a lot of people get it wrong. They still say, oh, Jesus is still. The Spirit is the one walking. Jesus said it is finished. His work had finished. He went to rest. So the Holy Spirit, that's why he had to send the Spirit of God to his representative to come and do the works. He says, and now, but it was the same Spirit that was walking through him in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. He says, and now I am no more in the world, but these are in the world. These are in the world. So he's not there, but you are there. That means you are his representative. That means you bear the name Jesus. It is your name. It is your name. By spiritual revelation, it is your name. He says, these are in the world, and I come to thee, Holy Father. Keep through thy own name those whom thou hast given me, that they may be one as we are one. That they may be one as we are one. That they may be one as we are one. Let's go in the name of Jesus Christ. Now you see, Jesus was a seed that was planted to it grew and it multiplied into a multitude of seeds. Jesus, yes. That's why you have salvation. When you are saved, you become one of those seeds. One of the seeds of Jesus, yes. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That's why the Bible says we are not born of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible seed. Nothing can corrupt it. It's from the Lord. It was given to you in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. And in it will you thrive. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That is why you will have the authority to ask for anything in his name and it will be done. Numbers 14:28. May God be glorified. He says, say unto them, and as I say unto you now, he says, as truly as I live. Do you believe he lives? He says, as truly as I live. He says, say unto the Lord, as he has spoken in my ears, so will I do unto you. That's why I wake up every day, I say, God, I will live and not die. No sickness can torment me. No sickness will even come near my dwelling in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My children will live. I will flourish in the land. Anywhere I set my foot upon, I will prosper. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You speak those words over yourself. He says, as truly as I live, saith the Lord, this is God committing himself. As truly as I live, he's telling you that this cannot be broken. This cannot be challenged. I have spoken. He says, as truly as I live, said the Lord, as you have spoken in my ear, so will I do unto you. That's why you have to be careful. When you say, I am sick, I'm not sick. You say, I am sick. I don't have money. I am broke. I am. That is the name of God. So you are telling, you are confessing that your God is broke. So if your God is broke, you will be broke. I am sick. I am broke. I am homeless. It is not your word. How can you say that? I am. He told you that he gave himself a name in Exodus. He says, I am. And then you are saying, God broke. That means your God is broke. God homeless. That means your God is homeless. So you'll be homeless. My God has a home. He has homes. He owns the world. So I can't be homeless. I can't be broke in the name of Jesus. I can't be sick in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, when I speak a word, it comes to pass. Receive life in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let's go to John. John again. Chapter 14. May God, the mighty God, may he alone be glorified. John chapter 14, verse 12 to 14. See what it says. It says, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, because you have the same power, you operate in the same name. He said, the works that I do, that's why I wrote a book. It's controversial. People don't understand that this book came by revelation. The ones that understand it understand. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So, the book was titled, and this was a book I refused to write. I was forced to write this book. And while I was writing this book, challenges up and down. Many times I almost deleted the book. But God said, write it in the name of Jesus. And it is titled, I am Jesus, not the Christ. So if you think, oh, somebody called me Antichrist because of this book, I say, get revelation. Who do you pray in his name? South Americans, are they committing sin by bearing the name Jesus? Get revelation. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. It's on Amazon. Go and get it. I am Jesus, not the Christ. Our first book, Kingdom, Freedom, and Wisdom, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I don't know what is coming. Our daily devotional, Let There Be Light, very soon on Amazon. You get it on bookstores as well, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It says, very, very, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he also do, and greater works than these. If you don't believe that you are bearing the name, how can you do greater works than Jesus? Jesus the Lord, how can you do greater works? But he said, greater works shall you do. Because he has done the work, he's going to rest, and you now take over. He's telling you to take over. He says, and whatsoever you shall ask in my name, that will I do. Even his name, because he gave you the name. He says, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. Anything. Ask now in the name of Jesus Christ. Ask him and receive in the mighty name of Jesus. Receive. It is your right as a believer. It is your right in the name of Jesus Christ. Covenant right. God is not a man that he should lie. Neither is he the Son of Man that he should repent. When he speaks, it comes to pass. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. May the Lord be glorified. And then in verse 16 to 17, it says, and I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, and he may abide with you forever, even the Spirit of truth. He said the world doesn't know him, in the mighty name of Jesus. And in verse 26, he says he will teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance. So dementia will never be your case in Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And I pray, as we close this program, if the Lord is leading you to support us, support the work in the name of Jesus Christ, and there will be light in your lives in Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And I pray for sound health, sound mind, in the name of Jesus Christ. I say shalom to you in the name of Jesus Christ. Sickness will not come near your dwelling in Jesus' name. The Lord empower you this day in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Lord, the living God, empower you this day in Jesus' name. And you will come back with testimonies. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. I say shalom again in Jesus' name. May God be glorified in Jesus' name. Amen.